The scatter plots and trend lines. So a scatter plot is a graph with points plotted to show a relationship. We've actually done scatter plots before. It's a point made up with, or a graph made up with points, right? It's a bunch of dots. Do you remember what we called this earlier this year when we did types of graphs? Started with a D. I heard it, discrete. It's just a bunch of dots all over the place. So in a scatter plot, there are two variables, right? There's the X variable and the Y variable. And it's usually shown with a big amount of data. Usually a scatter plot isn't just 5 pieces of data. Now, we're gonna do it with 5 pieces of data because I don't wanna hear you complain about having to graph 100 pieces of data. But usually a scatter plot is just a whole bunch of dots everywhere. And scatter plots are classified into 3 sets. There are 3 types of categories, and those categories are called correlations, or sometimes you can call them associations. A-S-S-O-C-I-A-T-I-O-N. Associations. And a correlation or an association can be positive, meaning it's trending up, it can be negative, meaning it's, oops, I forgot the R, trending down, or there can be no correlation, meaning it's just scattered. There's no trend. And Twitter has really helped understanding positive, negative, and no correlation. How many of you follow, have a Twitter account? Right? When you check Twitter, it'll tell you what things are trending right now. If lots of people are talking about it, it's a positive correlation. Its popularity is going up. If not very many people are talking about it, its popularity is going down. And no correlation, it's just random. So let's draw 3 different graphs. The first one is going to be a positive correlation. And again, it doesn't have to be beautiful. We're just going to use the first quadrant. And put random dots. Can you see how this is a positive correlation? It's going up. As you move across the graph, your data gets higher. A negative correlation is going to do the opposite. It's going to start out higher, but as you move across the graph, the data will come lower, will drop. And then last but not least is no correlation. What's that going to look like? Yeah, just dots kind of all over the place. Positive correlation, negative correlation, no correlation. You can also tell if something has positive, negative, or no correlation without a graph. So if you don't have a graph, maybe it says the number of empty seats in a class and the number of students absent. The number of empty seats in a class and the number of students that are absent. What are the two things we're measuring? What are the two variables we're measuring? Corbin, what's one of them? Number of absent students. And what else? The number of empty seats. If there are two things we're measuring, two variables, let's talk about them. Let's talk in terms of up and down, right? As the number of empty seats increases, I use thumbs up, right? As the number of empty seats increases, tell me about the number of students absent. Do the number of students absent increase or decrease? If there are two empty seats, how many students are absent? If there are two empty seats, how many students are absent? Two. If there are three empty seats, how many students are absent? If there are five empty seats, how many students are absent? So, as the number of students increases, goes up, tell me about the number of students absent. Does that go up? Does it go down? Or is there no correlation? It'll go up as the seats increase in absence, right? As the number of empty seats increase, so does the number of students. They both trend going up. And if they both go up, it's a positive correlation. Let's say the number of children and the number of breakable items. The number of children and the number of breakable items. So if you're gonna have a party or you're gonna invite a whole bunch of people over, right? The more children I invite to my house, right? As the number of children inside my house increases, am I gonna have more breakable items displayed, less breakable items displayed, or does it not matter because children don't break things? Yeah, as the number of children increase, the more kids I invite to my house, I'm going to hide all my breakable items, the less breakable items. So as one increases, the other decreases, meaning this is a negative correlation. Well, Miles, you are very trusting with your items around young children. So if you look, the number of empty seats, as this increases, so does your Y increase. And if they both increase, it goes up. But if you look here, as the number of young children increases, what happens to my breakable items? They decrease, so it goes down. So let's talk a no correlation. The number of books you read
and the number of cars you own.
Or you could say the number of books you read and your shoe size. So we're looking at the number of books you read and the number of cars you own. So my husband this weekend went on a reading rampage. He gets in those moods every once in a while. He read 3 books this weekend. We didn't talk to each other very much. So he read 3 books this weekend. Does that mean that we went out and bought a new car too? No. Right? The number of books you read, does it affect at all the number of cars you own? If I read more books, does that mean I get more cars?
No,
there's nothing. So as one goes up, we have a question mark about the other. It doesn't exist. There's no relationship. So this is no correlation. Guys, please close your computers. All right, so then let's talk about a trend line. A trend line helps show correlation. It's an estimate of the data. It helps with predictions. If you go back up to those 3 graphs you made up here, a trend line is just basically a line that goes to the middle of your data. It kind of follows the data. So this data shows me it doesn't quite start at the very bottom. It's a little bit above. Now your graph is going to look a little different than mine because they're freehand, right? So this trend line kind of looks like that. Can you draw a trend line for no correlation? No, it'd be right? So trend lines only work for positive and negative. But if I was going to extend this trend line, I could make a prediction for this piece of data right here. And if I was going to extend this trend line, I could make a prediction for over here. Right? Trend lines help us create predictions. All right, so your homework is a lot of positive, negative, no correlation. Reading a story, positive, negative, no correlation. Deal? Deal?